Hi, my name is Martin Keary. I'm the product manager of MuseScore, a free open source notation program used by millions of people. And I'm delighted to announce our latest version, MuseScore 3.6, a release that's all about engraving improvements. We've spent months working on a significant overhaul to the appearance of our sheet music, providing you with much more professional looking defaults. The best way of demonstrating what we've done is to compare it to a previous version. So let's open MuseScore 3.5 and set up a new score. First, I'll add the title, composer name, and copyright info, and then I'll add a few instruments. I definitely want a horn in here. Oh, and I'd like a violin and a cello as well. I forgot about the piccolo and flute. I'd like those too. And you know what? Let's have a trombone and also a B-flat clarinet. Right, let's go. And pretty much immediately, you can see problem number one, which is that the instruments have all appeared in the order that I added them and have not been arranged correctly at all. Horn, cello, flute, trombone, clarinet, piccolo, violin. Yeah, that's pretty miserable. Not to mention there's no bracketing of instrument groups either, which makes for an extremely incomplete looking score. It is of course possible to manually adjust all these things, but not only is that a little bit tedious, and dare I say it, annoying, it also adds an unnecessary learning curve for younger users who are only starting out in their compositional journey. In addition, the margins on this page are a little bit cramped. The typeface, which is a Times New Roman clone, is not especially nice to look at. You'll also notice this large gap at the bottom of the page, which can only be fixed by adding spacers between each instrument. Now let's open MuseScore 3.6 and set up the same score. First, you'll notice that as I add new instruments, they're automatically ordered according to standard orchestral convention, which you can see here in this dropdown. This contains other conventions too, like marching band for example. This doesn't prevent you from making unique customizations, by the way. In addition, you can now mark instruments as soloists, which will be positioned accordingly on the score. Now, if we look at our score, you'll see a lot of things have changed. First, that large gap has gone. This is because we've now introduced an automatic spacing system that picks the best possible default layout to suit your page size and ensemble type. If we look closer, you can see that, along with the correct ordering, the instrument families have also been bracketed together accurately too. You'll also notice that our page margins have been updated to more closely match those used in published scores. Then there's our new typeface, Edwin, which is an open license version of New Century Schoolbook, long a favourite of professional publishers like Boosey and Hawkes. But since there's no music written yet, you'll be forgiven for missing the largest change of all, our new notation font, Leland, which is named after Leland Smith, the creator of the now abandoned application Score, which was known for the amazing quality of its engraving. We've spent a lot of time finessing this font to be a world beater. If you want to watch a video about how it was made, you'll find a link in the description. In combination, these defaults will transform the appearance of sheet music in MuseScore. If you want to apply them to your existing scores, then open them in MuseScore 3.6 and first apply the new typeface and notation style in this dialog. If you want to take advantage of our improved spacing, then go to Styles and choose Reset All Styles to Default. For extra credit, you might also want to choose this option to hide empty staves too. If you've spent a lot of time using page breaks and spacers in previous versions of MuseScore, it's advisable to remove them first to let the vertical spacing system do its thing. You can then make any changes you see fit afterwards. In general, you'll find that our new system requires a lot less manual tweaking with much better overall results. Lastly, if you want to avail of our automatic instrument ordering and bracketing, then open the Instruments panel by going to Edit Instruments. You can also press the shortcut I to do this, and change the ordering to your preferred convention. It's worth also mentioning that although these new defaults mark a giant step in the engraving quality of MuseScore, we're by no means done, and you'll be seeing further big advancements in the future. In addition to these large changes, there are dozens of improvements that have been added too. If you'd like to read through the full release list, the link is in the description. Lastly, I'd like to offer a massive thank you to our community, who've spent enormous amounts of time building and testing many of the features we're announcing today, with a special mention going out to Nick Vandenberg, who collaborated on many of these large changes with our engraving expert, Simon Smith. MuseScore is a truly wonderful open source project, and the community is its superpower. We hope you enjoy the numerous engraving changes we've introduced in MuseScore 3.6, and as always, there's much more to come.